You are watching our quick guide on how to understand my bill. This short video will walk you through the recommended approach, the important terms to know, and next steps for managing Azure costs. The first step is to download your invoice. To do this, you'll first sign into the Azure portal. You'll then select the billing icon on the left. You'll select invoices in the blade that pops up, and then you'll select the subscription that you're interested in the drop-down menu. Finally, you'll click on download invoice to open a PDF copy of the selected period statement. The second step is to download your detailed usage file. To do this, you'll first sign into the Azure Account Center. Note that only the account administrator can access the Azure Account Center. Other billing admins, such as the owner, can get usage information using billing APIs. Next, you'll select the same subscription that you selected when downloading your invoice. Then select billing history. Finally, click download usage to open a CSV file containing the details of each resource's daily usage and charges. Now that you have your invoice and your usage report downloaded, you're ready to understand your bill. The biggest reason you may not understand your bill is because you have a charge you don't recognize or you didn't expect. So first, you want to find the charge you're interested in the usage charges section of the invoice. In this example, we have selected scheduler. Second, you'll find the scheduler charge in the statement section of the usage report. By comparing charges, you can make sure they match in both reports and get further detail in the usage report. To see a breakdown of this charge on a daily basis, you can go to the daily usage section of the CSV. Here's some of the daily detailed usage highlighted. In total, all the daily detailed usages should add up to the consumed quantity in the statement section of the CSV and in the line item of the invoice. If you still have questions about a particular charge, you can open a support ticket through the Azure portal. It's important to note that many of the terms have the same meanings between the invoice and the detailed usage file, but with different names. So for example, resource is equivalent to meter name in the detailed usage file. You can see here that as well that billable on the invoice is the same as overage quantity on the usage report. Here's the full list of terms you can compare. Now that you've compared charges and terms, you may want to begin managing costs in Azure. You can do so by visiting the Cost Analysis tab of the Azure portal. Here you can find charts like current cost by resource or burn rate, which is the current and forecasted cost of the subscription. These can be helpful for seeing where you're spending the most and adjusting your usage to save money. As well, if you're interested in more information, you can learn more at Prevent Unexpected Costs with Azure. There are four other resources you should be aware of. The first is Microsoft's documentation on understanding your bill. This builds on the content in this video. The second is the documentation on descriptions of different terms you'll encounter in the Azure usage report. And the third is a document on how to use tags to organize Azure resources. To recap, to understand your Azure bill, you'll want to compare charges on your invoice with the detailed usage file. To start managing costs for different Azure resources, you can get started at the cost analysis blade in the subscription section of the Azure portal. Thank you for watching our quick guide.